Welcome to the show, everybody. This is the John Lennon birthday show, and I want to tell you, this is my 28th show. That means I've been doing this for 7 months. What? And with your folks' support and being there, we're going to go another 7 months. What do you think about that? Hopefully I can do this in an actual venue one of these days, and you guys can come see me. I'm going to keep going here. Why stop now, right? I haven't played one of these harmonica gizmo things in a while, so let's give this one a go. I'm a loser, I'm a loser, and I'm not what I appear to be. Oh, all the love I have won or have lost, I should never have crossed. She was a girl in a million, my friend. I should have known she would win in the end. I'm a loser, and I lost someone who's dear to me. I'm a loser, and I'm not like a clown. Beneath this mask I am wearing a crown. My tears are falling like rain from the sky. Is it for her or myself that I cry? I'm a loser, and I lost someone who did me. I'm a loser, and I'm not what I appear. Thank you. such a fate. I realize I have left it too late. And so it's true, pride comes before a fall. I'm telling you so that you won't lose all. I'm a loser, and I lost someone who's near to me. I'm a loser, and I'm not that I am near to me. All right, what do you think about them apples? Whoa, what a start. I thought I'd start out a little bit different tonight, so I hope you don't mind. John Lennon's 80th birthday coming up on the 9th, and wow, if only he were here today, what great music he would be making. I tell you, those harmonicas are challenging wearing that thing. My dentist said I could take it off after those songs. So anyway, great to see you. Great to have you here. Here's to the 28th show. That means I'm into my third season. 13 weeks. I'm into my third season. I love it. Welcome to all the folks that have been here before. I just cherish your support. All the newcomers, fantastic to see you too. And here's a little drink in your honor. Yeah, without you, I would have nothing. I would have nothing. And by the way, as always, my show is free. It is free, my brothers and sisters. I want you to enjoy. Sit back, make some popcorn, whatever you do at home. And enjoy yourselves. And if you like what I'm doing here, if you like what I've done in the past, and if you'd like to see me do more shows in the future, by all means, please hit the PayPal link or the Venmo link and send in something. Anything would be greatly appreciated to help me keep this thing going. A portion of the proceeds always goes to MusiCares, which helps musicians in times of need such as this, and it's an affiliation with the Recording Academy and Spotify. The good people at Spotify, they are going to match the funds 100%. So it's a great thing for everyone. And if you do send in something, I will send you a personal note. I always do. I'm very appreciative. Thank you so much once again for being here. I'd like to invite you to go to my website, billyhinsche.com. There's all kinds of movie trailers you can watch. They're all free, my brothers and sisters. Photos, backstage stuff. There's a link to Cameo. I just got a request today from someone. He wanted me to sing Forever for his wife, so I'm going to do that for him, for her, video shout out. And I teach piano and guitar from ages 8 to 80. Never too late to pick up an instrument, I always say, so let me know if I can help you in that regard, or if you want to sing, write songs, whatever is clever, let me know. Thank you, John Stamos, for being my first Zoom call-in guest last week. If you were with me, I was at a virtual Vegas studio, it's called. And that was a very special event. We had clips and photos, and as I said, John Stamos called in for a great Zoom interview. A lot of laughs, a lot of fun. And I'm going to be going back to that, either that studio or another venue in Las Vegas. So stay tuned. That's going to be October 24th. That's going to be a very special show. I'm thinking of doing, I'm going to call it the Good Vibrations Beach Boys Show. All Beach Boys songs. It's going to be great. I'm excited. I'll let you know. Join my YouTube channel, please. That would be awesome if you could do that. I still need a couple more people to reach 100, so that'd be great. Bill Mumy, thank you for the PSA. The great actor, fine musician, good buddy, Bill Mumy. Thank you for the beautiful PSA you did for me this week. Greer Upton, my dearest friend from grammar school, my sister's best friend. Thank you, Greer, for the beautiful graphic. And, I want to congratulate Leslie Barbs. She won the trivia contest last week. She correctly named Steubenville, Ohio, as the birthplace of Dean Crocetti, aka Dean Martin. So congratulations. I sent Leslie an autographed copy of, what did I send her? Something great. I think it was a DVD. Yeah, I think it's a DVD. I forget, actually. But you'll get it any day now, Leslie. You'll get it any day. Anyway, I'm going to sing my usual opener here. And sort of doing the show a little bit out of order, but what the hey, special night, right? Did you know that while I was a musician, I worked at a bank for a while. Worked at a bank. It didn't work out, though. I lost interest. Uh-oh. Hello, my friends. It's good to see you again. I guess it's been a few years since I've been away. But I'm happy to say I'm doing okay myself. I can dig what's happening. And every day there is something new and hey. Good things are coming my way. So tell me, how have you been? There's so much you gotta tell me. Let's talk about them good old days when we laugh and say, hey, hey, you're okay. Let's take it nice and easy now. It's a brand new year. Lots of things are happening, and hey, good things are coming my way. Tell me, have you been? There's so much you gotta tell me. Let's talk about them good old days when they be laughing and say, hey, 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 life, okay. That groove. Stick around for a couple of days, cause hey, good things are coming my way. Good things are coming my way. My way. Susie Cincinnati's got a and her husband's a security guard. Her looks aren't exactly a plus, but it doesn't matter to us. Cause she gets you there, she'll get you there in seconds flat. I certainly hope that the Al Jardine didn't mind that I borrowed a little bit of his great song, Susie Cincinnati. You don't hear that one very often, but that's why I'm here, to play the unexpected. Oh boy, well that was fun. I got a lot of show to do. Boy, this is a great honor to John Lennon. I saw him on Ed Sullivan's show. He came out there with his 325 Rickenbacker Jet Glow, which is their color for black, and man oh man, I never seen a guitar like that before. You know, George was playing his Country Gentleman, and McCartney had his odd looking violin Hofner bass. I'd never seen one of those either. And he was playing left-handed, and Ringo back there. Anyway, great memories of seeing John. Saw the Beatles a couple of times at the Hollywood Bowl. Yes, I did. And 64, 65. And I tell you, so memorable. And when I think about it, when I was putting together this set list for tonight, oh my gosh, what a wealth of songs John wrote. Of course, Lennon, McCartney, but I mean, these are songs that that John sang, you know, all by himself. And I think if he were around today, if he went out and did a show of just his songs, you know, sort of like the way McCartney does, man, what a blockbuster show that would be. That would be absolutely incredible. Anyway, just thinking about it and speculating, it would be a beautiful thing. I'm going to sing another song. Let's keep this party going. This song, Carl loved this song. I remember when it came out. He loved this one. Sorry, I'm having a memory lapse.
You better run for your life if you can, little girl. I just had to say, little girl, can't you win another man? That's the end, little girl. Now let this be a sermon. I mean everything I said. But maybe I'm determined that I'd rather see you dead. You better run for your life if you can, little girl.
And of course, you know, the Beatles were so loved and respected by even the Beach Boys that they even did a song on the Party album, of which I played harmonica on. Thank you very much. I like to promote that as much as I can. Mountain of Love, harmonica, check it out. That's me. Dennis sang this one.
Here I stand, head in hand, turn my face to the wall. If she's gone, I can't go on, feeling 2 foot small. Everywhere people stare, each and every day. Love away.
indeed. Well, yeah, I remember going to see the guys at the Hollywood Bowl, and I remember Carl telling me that Carl Wilson, he and Mike Love chartered a Learjet and flew to Seattle to meet the Beatles. Isn't that incredible? I remember hearing that. Carl told me that. I was like, you did what? You rented a Learjet? Wow, that is intense. But that's how great of fans they were of the Beatles. I think they might have been, you know, on tour like in Salt Lake or something. And I said, hey, let's just go meet the guys. So that's what they did. That was a long time ago, and they remained all friends to this day. And I have some more songs to sing. I hope you don't mind. I'm here to sing. I got some other stories to tell, but how about this one? You know, I have an addiction of sorts, a compulsion, you might say. I collect original Beatles albums, and I need help.
When I was young, and so much younger than today, I never needed anybody's help in any way. And now those days are gone, I'm not so self-assured. Try to change my mind, I've opened up the door. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do.
Indeed. Well, I remember a time when my friend Dino, you know, he loved cars. And gosh, he had a lot of exotic cars. He had, you know, Ferraris and Lamborghinis and, you know, all kinds of beautiful cars. And one day I went up to his home, his father's home, and he had just purchased a beautiful royal blue, navy blue Mini Cooper with darked out windows. I don't mean lightly tinted windows. I mean like so dark, no way could you penetrate and see who was inside. It was right-hand drive. He said, come on, let's go for a ride. He's over here driving, stick shift, so comfortable, so beautiful. Gray leather interior and carpeting, really plush, lush carpeting. And he says, I bought this from Mama Cass. And it once belonged to John Lennon. And I was like, wow, impressed. I'm actually in John Lennon's Mini Cooper. It's like, wow. And I remember going inside the house, and Mr. Martin was there, Dean Martin was there, and he says to me, I see Dino's driving that hearse again. He called it a hearse. So funny. And then, here's another John Lennon car story. So the story goes, Brian and Marilyn Wilson bought John's chocolate brown Rolls Royce. It was gorgeous, the most beautiful Rolls Royce I've ever seen to this day. Chocolate brown, darked out windows, just like that Mini Cooper that Dino had. And Dennis was driving over. Oh, Dennis borrowed, he said to Brian, hey, can I, you know, I'd like to buy that car from you. Do you mind if I buy the car from you? I don't think he ever paid them. Such a Dennis move. And anyway, I remember I was driving over Coldwater Canyon with Carl and Annie, my sister, in their Aston Martin, and Dennis pulls up and you know, you gotta come to my house. We were on our way to meditate with Maharishi, with Mike and Brian, and I said, sure. And afterwards, I jumped in Dennis's this beautiful Rolls Royce, and so here I am riding around in John Lennon's other car, other Rolls Royce, incredible. Both beautiful cars. Well, those are my car stories for you, John Lennon car stories. So, I think I should sing another song. This is one of my favorites. Actually, all these songs are my favorites that John sang, but I had to, you know, sort of whittle them down. Struck me when I hear some of these songs about, you know, like that, or several others, you know, where they don't get the girl. John doesn't get the girl. It's like, what? You know, he's a Beatle. What do you mean? He couldn't get the girl? You know, Paul has him, George, Ringo, they all have songs about not getting the girl. I mean, that said to me, like, what chance do I have if the Beatles can't get the girl that they want? Oh Lord. Here is just a beautiful beautiful song that I'd like to play for you now. But of all these
that went before. I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more. In my life, I love you more. In my
okay. What do you think about that? Thumbs up? One of my favorites. Could be my favorite Beatles song. I know that's saying a lot, but I think it may be true. I'm going to take a little sip here and tell you a couple more stories. What do you think about that? This would be my house drink. Lipton cold brew iced tea. Dash of Pellegrino, a little lemonade, lots of ice, and a squeeze of lemon and a little lemon wedge to sort of round things out. And here's to your good health and mine. So my friend Ricky Martin, he has his 21st birthday. I told this story in an earlier episode of my Billy's Place series. And it was the party of all time. His mother, Jeannie Martin, wanted to do something special. So she asked me if I'd like to write a song or do something, which I did. I wrote like a little birthday song. I'll play a little bit for you. Just a little. Yeah.
This is your special day.
But beyond that, the guest list included, in no particular order, Henry Mancini, Brian Wilson, Elizabeth Taylor, David Bowie, and who walks in the front door, and I'm standing there on the staircase, I'm the only one there at the time, in walks John Lennon, Elton John, Kiki D, Ringo Starr shows up later, May Pang, and what a scene for me. I mean, you know, Beatles fan that I am. There's John Lennon standing right there and looked great, very calm and peaceful, even though it was known as the Lost Weekend, but he was looking great. And Dino came in to greet him, and they went down, and they all sat in this area that ironically was the area that Dino Desi and I had done our audition for Frank Sinatra several years prior. And I knew Kiki D because she had opened for the Beach Boys on a couple of tours. This was 1974. So that's the era that I'm talking about here. And I kind of walked up to Kiki. Hi, Kiki. Now Elton's here. John's here. And I'm talking to her, and how you doing? And I just didn't have the courage to say, would you introduce me to that guy behind you? And I just never did, and I'm still telling the story of how I regret that I didn't do that. But I got awful close to, I was in the presence of John Lennon, which was very cool. That was really special. I've got another funny story that there's a drummer, well-known drummer, Vinny Appice. His brother Carmine is also well-known. He's in Vanilla Fudge. Anyway, Vinny tells the story of how he was doing sessions for John in New York. And so his mother, being Italian, made a beautiful lasagna for John, and she put it in one of her pans, you know, and gave it to Vinny and said, here, give this to John. So Vinny takes the lasagna to John, and, you know, oh, thank you so much. And so there comes a time when Vinny's mother was invited to go to the studio. And so there's John, and she walks up and says hello to John, and she says, "Have you got the pan?" See, she wanted the pan back. My mother would say the same thing, you know what I mean? If you have a mother that likes to cook, you'll understand that story. Anyway, that is pretty funny. I gave my buddy Bruce Johnston a call, and he told me a great story. Excuse me. He says that it was around the time of the Magical Mystery Tour premiere in London, and the Beach Boys had just done this show in Paris with Maharishi, and the Beatles were in attendance. Actually, I have a my sister's story precedes this. Yeah, my sister Annie said that on the way back from Paris, on the flight, there was Marlon Brando and the Beach Boys, and Dennis and Marlon Brando hook up. Gee, what a surprise, you know, that they made a connection. So they went off when they got to London and were roaming around, but when Carl and Annie got to their room, it might have been the Hilton, London Hilton, John Lennon and George Harrison show up. And they come in and they start talking, and Dennis was there at the time, and they start talking about TM and the benefits of transcendental meditation and all of this. It was quite a thing. I talked to her just today about it. And so this dovetails into Bruce's story of around exactly that same time, the Magical Mystery Tour debut occurred. And there was a dress-up party, a costume party. I think they call it like a dress-up party, something like that. And he went as a Sergeant Pepper character, you know. And he was with Mike Love. So they go to this party. And because I called him and I said, "Bruce, have you got a John Lennon story? I'm going to be doing a John Lennon show." And he said, "Yeah, so this is the story I'm telling you, the viewer." So he's talking to John, and John was with his father, who he had just met a few months earlier. His name was Freddie Lennon. And John explained how his father was a steward on the Cunard line of ships that went back and forth from England to the East Coast. And that John was saying how a lot of the records that he and his friends got were brought over from the States by young stewards from the U.S., Americans that would bring over the Motown hits and, you know, all kinds of great tunes. So that's how they were introduced to a lot of rhythm and blues and just American style music. So Bruce tells me how at one point in the evening, this band called the Bonzo Dog Doodah Band start to play, and that he and Mike, John, Ringo, and Paul get up on stage, no George, and they do versions of California Girls and Sloop John B. I mean, can you imagine being at that party? Anyway, what great memories. I'm going to play a couple more songs. Oh, did you hear about the new fast food restaurant called Instant Karma? Have you heard about that? No menu. You get what you deserve. Uh-oh. Is there anybody gone to listen to my story? All about the girl that came to stay. She's the kind of girl you want so much it makes you sorry. Still you don't regret a single day. Girl.
young man. La 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 la, he's as fine as he can be. Just sees what he wants to see. Nowhere, man, can you see me at all. Nowhere, man, don't worry, take your time. Don't hurry, leave it all to somebody else. Lends you a hand. La la la, he's a real nowhere man, sitting in his nowhere land. Making all his nowhere plans for nobody. Making all his nowhere plans for nobody.
Nowhere man. What can I say? Oh, and by the way, Dino, Desiree's, and Bilski's, we recorded that. I mean, Dino, Desi, and Billy. We recorded that on one of our four albums that we recorded for reprise. I don't know what's wrong with my mouth tonight. I've got a trivia contest I want to do. That's what I want to do. And it goes something like this. If you can guess my little question here, I will send you this autographed DVD that I made. You know, I'm a film student, motion pictures and television from UCLA. This is called 24 Hours. This is when I was on the road with the Beach Boys and we did we were in five cities in 5 days. We woke up in Kansas City, Missouri. We drove to Sedalia, Missouri, did a show, got on the charter, flew to Jefferson City, Missouri, did a show, went to Memphis, Tennessee, and then ended up in Boston. You have to see this to believe it. So I'll be happy to autograph this and send it to whomever gets this question correct. And it goes like this. It's a little tricky, so listen carefully. The Beatles recorded a song, and from that musical theme, the Beach Boys recorded a song. Brian wrote a song with a similar musical theme. I'd like to know what the Beatles song was and that inspired the Beach Boys to release a song that was had a similar musical theme. Does that make sense? I hope so, because I'm about to play those two songs back to back. I hope somebody guesses this. Beatles write a song, musical theme running throughout, Beach Boys record sort of an answer. So, write in your answers, I'll review, and I'll look at all the answers and the questions and the answers and see who came in first. So, here I go.
I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today, yeah. The girl that's driving me mad is going away. Oh, she's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. That living with me was bringing her down, yeah. She would never be free when I was around. Oh, she's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She don't care. I don't know why she's riding so high. She's gonna think twice, she's gonna do right by me before you get to say goodbye. She's gonna think twice. twice, she's gonna do right by me.
To the questions. Ticket to Ride, Begat, Girl Don't Tell Me, so to speak. And I'll have you know that Dino Desi and Billy recorded that. I chose to sing that on an early Dino Desi and Billy album because in respect for Carl, because Carl was dating my sister Annie, and you know, I thought it was a great song, and it is. So I recorded it. What the heck? I got a couple of more songs I want to do for you. I hope you're enjoying the show. If you are, do something. Send up a smoke signal. Oh, boy. I'm a little dry, Gulch. You know, I was driving down the street today and this truck overturned. It was a Scrabble truck and all the little pieces went everywhere. And I asked the driver, "Say, man, what's the word on the street?" Oh, Lord. Oh, here's another one of my favorites. Oh, boy. I'm going to move this over here so I can see you better and you can see me better. Is that all right? Okay. My notes just jumped. This is my poor man's teleprompter. Hope you don't mind. It's just my iPad, but it works for me. If you were red tonight, remember what I said. For red is the color that my baby wore, and what's more, it's true. Yes, it is. Scarlet were the clothes she wore. Everybody knows, I'm sure.
true. Yes, you did. I could be happy with you by my side if I could forget her. But it's my pride. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Oh, yes, it is. Oh, yeah. Please don't wear red tonight. This is what I said tonight. For red is the color that will make me blue in spite of you. It's true. Yes, it is. It's true. Yes, it is.
One of my favorite songs. Oh my. How about this one?
Words are flowing out like endless rain into a paper cup. They slither wildly as they slip away across the universe. Pools of sorrow, waves of joy are drifting through my open mind, possessing and caressing me. Jai Guru Deva. Imagine there's no position.
I wonder if you can. No greed or hunger, a brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us and the world we live is one. Oh, what a beautiful song. There was a time when the Beach Boys did that song, and I had the privilege of playing the piano on that for them during that period of time. So, well, I hope you've enjoyed my show. I've really had a blast. I mean, I wish I could play all night long. There's so many great songs. But I'm going to wind it on down here and say I hope to see you next week. I've already got an idea for a show in mind. Do you want me to tell you what it is? I'll tell you what it is. I'm going to do a show all about the great songs of the Eagles. I hope you can make it. I hope I'll be there, God willing, and the creek don't rise. And thank you so much for being here with me tonight. It's been a special night. Happy birthday, John. 80 years old he would have been. God bless. May I say, if you've enjoyed the show, if you want to see more, come back, see that Eagles show next week. I would be so happy if you send in a little something via PayPal or Venmo. A portion of the proceeds is going to benefit Music Cares and the musicians of this world who are suffering. So do that, and I'll write you a little personal note, and I will be happy to do that. And let's see, any other announcements? Yeah, you know, go sign up for my YouTube channel. That would be great. Go to my website, and I am going to leave with my usual song. Positivity every day. Positivity in every way. Positivity is what I need. Positivity, yes indeed. Let's go. Positivity is my friend. Positivity through thick and thin. Let's go! Positivity is good for my soul. Positivity for young and old. Positivity for everyone. Positivity, we've just begun. That's right. So much for being here with me tonight, and God bless you and your families, and I wish only the greatest, the bestest things for you that this wonderful life can bring. Good night.